Hello students, next part of the curve fitting is fitting a second degree parabola y is equal to ax square plus bx plus c. Okay, they are told to fit a parabola, means our curve is parabola here, and that is given by y is equal to ax square plus bx plus c. Now we need to fit a curve for parabola. Okay, for that one consider y is equal to ax square plus bx plus c. Okay, this is our curve with the set of integers x1. Next, then consider the residual of at least a square, that is r is equal to y minus ax square plus bx plus c. Next, let s be the sum of these residual squares. Let s be the sum of residual square, that is s equals summation 1 to n into bracket y minus ax square into y minus into bracket ax square plus bx plus c whole square. Next, now next we need to find the necessary conditions for S where we have the parameters A, B, C. Here we need to find the necessary conditions for S for the parameters A, B, C. And that, let us consider that necessary conditions to be minimum. That is, dou S by dou A is equal to 0, dou S by dou B is equal to 0, dou S by dou C equals to 0. Means, partially differentiating this with respect to A once, with respect to B second time, with respect to C another time. That is 2 into summation of 1 into y minus ax square plus bx plus c. Next, the first one is with respect to A, therefore it is minus x square, A becomes 1. Next, with respect to B, that is 2 into summation 1 to n y minus ax square plus bx plus c. With respect to B, therefore B becomes 1, therefore it is minus x. Next, with respect to C, 2 into summation 1 to n y minus ax square plus bx plus c into bracket minus 1. With respect to C, therefore it is minus 1 equals to 0. In the next step, dividing by 2 to all these equations, we are getting summation 1 to n x square y plus summation 1 to n ax raised to 4, means dividing by 2 and multiplying x square to this bracket minus x to this bracket minus 1 to this bracket. That is minus of summation 1 to n x square y plus summation 1 to n ax raised to 4 plus summation 1 to n bx cube plus summation 1 to n cx square equals to 0, x multiplying minus x to the bracket terms. Minus 1 to n x y plus 1 to n summation 1 to n ax cube plus summation 1 to n bx square plus summation 1 to n cx equals to 0. Next, multiply minus 1 to the bracket and dividing by 2, minus summation 1 to n y plus summation 1 to n ax square plus summation 1 to n bx plus summation 1 to n c. Here they have given c, summation of c from 1 to n. That you can write it as c plus c plus c up to n times. Up to n times, this is nothing but nc. Then we can write the equations of a into summation x raised to 4, b into summation x cube, c into summation x square equals summation of x square y. Means taking these a, b, c outside. Next, a into summation x cube plus b into summation x square plus c into summation x equals to summation x y. A into summation x square plus b into summation of x plus, just here it is summation of 1 to n c is nothing but n times of c. That here we are writing n c is equal to summation of 1. Okay, these are the nothing but normal equation. These are the normal equation to fit a second degree parabola y is equal to ax square plus bx plus c. Next, we will see the example. Fit a second degree parabola y is equal to x square plus bx plus c in the least square sense for the following data and hence estimate y at y x equals to 6. Yes, they are asking to fit a curve here. Fitting a curve, second degree parabola means here we need to find the parameters a, b, c values. Okay. To find that one, they have given a data x, y. X 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, y 10, 12, 13, 16, 19. Okay, next, after finding y equation, that is this one, they are asking to find the value of y when x equals to 6. Okay, first to find filter equation y equals to ax square plus bx c, bx plus c. Let us have the normal equations associated with y equals to ax square plus bx plus c. Those are nothing but summation y equals to a into summation x square plus b into summation of x plus n c. Just now we have proved these normal equations, the same equation. Summation x y equals to a into summation of x2 plus b into summation x square plus c into summation x. Next, summation x square y equals to a into summation x raised to 4 plus b into summation x cube plus c into summation x square. So if just look at here, these are nothing but equations. These are nothing but three equations are there. To find the value of ABC, ABC values, we need x, x square, summation ix, summation x square, summation x cube, summation x raised to 4, summation x y, summation x square y. Means to find these all data values, they have given x and y data. With the help of x and y, we will find the summation x, summation y. Next, with the help of, we will find first x square, x cube, x raised to 4. Next, summation of all these terms. Next, we will find xy, x square, y, and summation of those two terms. And here, n they have given, n is equals to 5. N is equals to 5. To find those all required values, we will have a table. Means with the help of a table, we will find all the terms, required terms. X values are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Next, y, summation of x. Summation of x, it is 40, right? Sorry, 50. Next, y. Y is equals to. Y is equals to. Next, or 10, 12, 13, 16, 19. Summation of y is equals to. It is 70. Next term we wrote xy. Xy is equals to. Means, multiplying these two terms, it is 10. 2 into 12 is 24. 3 into 13, 39, 4 into 16, 64, 19 into 5, 95. Next, summation of xy. Summation of xy, it is 232. Next term we need what? X square y. Okay, to find x square y, first we will find x square. Means, square of these terms, 1 square 1. 2 square 4, 3 square 9, 16, 25. Next, summation of x square. Summation of x square is 55. Next, third is x square y. X square y is multiplying these two. Is 10, 12 into 4, 48, 13 into 9. 13 into 9, it is 117, 16 into 16, 256, 19 into 24, 475. Next, summation of x square y. This equals to 906. We just look here, what are all terms we find here now? Summation 1 over, summation of x square, summation of x. Next, we need summation of x cube. Summation of x square is also over. Summation x square of y is also over. Next we need summation of x cube. Summation of x raised to 4. Means first we will find x cube of all the x terms. That is 1 cube 1, 2 cube 8, 9 cube 27. So 3 cube 27, 4 cube it is 64. 5 cube 125. Summation of x cube equals to 225. Meaning x is to 4. X is to 4. 1 is to 4 1. 2 is to 4 16. 3 is to 4 181. Next 4 is to 4. 4 is to 4 is 256. Right. This is the table of required that with the help of given data we have find all the required values. Okay. It should be in the form of a table. We draw a table. Table contains the marks. Okay. Try to draw it neatly as much as possible. Because this table only gives the clear idea about the required data. Therefore, the table is must.
Okay.
Next one. We will substitute all these values in the normal equation. First one, summation y. Summation y is 70. 70 is equals to a. Summation x square y. Summation x square y is 55. A. Next. B into summation of x. That is 15b. Plus nc. Nc means it is 5c. Next one, summation x y. Summation x y is 232. A into summation x cube. Summation x cube is 225. A plus next b into summation x square or summation x square b, that is 55b plus c into summation x 15c. Next summation x square y, it is here 906. A into summation x is 4, 979. X is a plus 225 b plus 55 c. Okay, here we need to find the values of a, b, c. Okay, after we need to solve these all equations. Here we find the values of a, b, c by these equations. Here we are using the calculator fx100. Means fx100 will help you to find the unknown quantities. On solving equations by using calculators, by using calculator, we have a is equals to 0.2857, which is nearly 0.29. B is equals to 0.4857, which is nearly 0.49, and C is equals to 9.4. Okay, now we will substitute or we will fit the curve. Therefore, the curve to be fit. The curve on our curve is equation of parabola. The curve to be fit is y is equals to ax square. A is 0.29 x square plus bx, that is 0.49b plus c, that is 9.4. This is one part. They are telling fit a second degree parabola, means it's over. Next, they are asking hence estimate the value of y at x equals to 6, means find the value of y by putting the value of 6, that is 0.296 square plus 0.49 into 6 plus 9.4. Okay. Simplify this one. After simplifying, we are getting the value of y is 22.7.